Hey guys, what's going on guys? Today, we're going to quickly cover some weapon option as well as artifact option for Tartaglia or Childe. So Childe is a Hydro main DPS. This means you'll mostly be hitting for Hydro or blue numbers. We can take a look quickly by looking at his melee form first, where it converts all his normal attack damage as well as charge attack into Hydro. When he does his attack in this form, hitting his riptide also produces AoE Hydro damage. His elemental burst, I don't have to say, it obviously does hydro damage in bow form, in the range form, as well as in the melee form. It does an additional explosion if you hit a target with a riptide in your melee elemental burst, and again, doing more hydro damage. What this means is that you should prioritize hydro damage on your Childe. Now, this is interesting because his normal range attack does normal damage. This is not hydro damage. So what you instead should be doing is using your charge attack a lot of the time, because your charge attack do hydro damage, and since you're building hydro damage, you're able to get the hydro damage multiplier. Additionally, your charge attack will do riptide on every single one of your attack. It will chain riptide one off another and doing more hydro damage, and this is the primary reason why you should build hydro damage as well as a charge damage build. One of the reasons why I want to do a charge build is because you can't stay in melee stand forever unless you have C6, in which case that's a whale category and we're not going to cover it in this video. And so, because of the cooldown only start once you re-enter the range stance, it is unavoidable to have a very very long cooldown and you're going to be forced to use your range stand mode. This brings us into the topic of cooldown management. The way you should be playing Childe is, while you're in start of your melee stand, spend all your stamina during charge attack and then switch to your support, casting their skill and making sure that you can utilize those uptime, then switch back to Childe, and while you're still waiting for that cooldown on your Yi, this is the opportunity for you to use your charge attack, providing both hydro damage as well as start taking the riptide out. The strongest weapon for Childe is undoubtedly the Skyward Harp, as they have a secondary stat of crit rate and it provides a crit damage passive. Crit damage and crit rate are both really strong stat on Childe, and so Skyward Harp take the number one spot. For the 4-star selection, we have the Stringless or the Battle Pass Bow, the very decent hunt. Now, the Battle Pass Bow is really nice because you have a secondary style of crit rate. Crit rate is really important, it allows Childe to continuously procing his Riptide Float when it's in melee stand. But the Stringless is not bad as well. The Stringless provide both elemental skill damage as well as elemental burst damage. Elemental skill damage increments his damage on the Riptide during his melee form. And his elemental burst damage is really nice because he has a really high scaling elemental burst, making a Stringless a really good weapon as well. Finally, we have the Rust weapon. The Rust weapon provides normal attack damage and decrease your aim shot damage. Now, since this build mostly focuses on charge damage, it might look unintuitive to put this weapon on. However, it's an alright weapon when you have nothing else better. It's important to know that while in his ranged stance, his riptide damage is actually considered normal attack damage. So overall, the Rust is also a solid choice for him as well. For the artifact, we're going to be using the Wanderer set because its 4-piece bonus provides us a 35% increase in charge attack damage. Now, while Childe has a melee form, since he uses the bow, this 35% charge damage still apply when he's in his melee form. And so this is what allows us to dish out those big crit number when we're using our charge attack in either ranged aim shot mode or in our melee charge attack. While you're still working toward your 4-set wanderer, you can consider some 2 and 2 set. Here I'm using a 2 gladiator and a 2 wanderer set, with the gladiator providing 18% attack. You can replace this wanderer set with the noblest set if you're looking for elemental burst damage, it's really nice as well. Or if you're missing some crit rate, you can use the Berserker set for the 12% crit rate to temporarily boost your crit rate. You want to be aiming for 50 or around 60% crit rate before you start working on your other stuff. Now for the substat, it's really standard. For the helmet, you want to be looking for crit rate or crit damage depending on which one you're missing more. If you're under 50% crit rate, I'll definitely look to aim for crit rate. For the goblet, you're going to want to look for hydro damage for sure. And for the hourglass, simply looking for attack is good enough. That's it for this build, guys. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you guys all next time.